Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to load tab items from a local JSON collection and remote data source in the Angular Tabs component. First, let me open my existing Angular application, where I have added the Angular Tab component with three tab items. Here, the tab item header and its content are bound from the define object and string array. I have aligned the component using a CSS class property and positioned the tab header at the top. If you would like to know how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Angular Tab component to it, click the video link in the card above. I run this example using the command ng-serve. Looking at the output page now, the Angular Tab component displayed with three different tabs. Next, I will show you how to add tab items to the component by looping the JSON collection. To achieve this, I need to create a JSON collection with the fields, header, and content. This header field should have nested field text because the Angular Tab component header model is structured like this. If you want to know more about this tab header model, you can check the documentation page shown in the card. First, I will create an object array, countries, and assign an array of objects with two fields, header and content. As you know, I am going to load tab items by looping the JSON collection. So, I will use ng4, built-in directive, to create tab item for each item in the array. To do this, I will open the app component HTML file and maintain a single etab item tag by removing the other two tab items. Then, I add the ng for directive and create a local variable to iterate this JSON collection. Look here, of countries means you are going to iterate over this country's array. Next, I need to map appropriate fields to the header and content properties. Here, I will map the header field to the header property and content field to the content property. Looking at the output page now, the tab component displays four different tab items like India, Canada, London, and Germany. Next, I will show you how to load tab items from a remote data source. For this, I am going to use the Data Manager component. As a first step, I import the Data Manager and required adapter from the EJ2 data repository. Second, I initialize the ng on init method and create a new instance for the data manager with the properties URL and adapter. In the URL, I use the already available remote URL service, which retrieves the list of data through a post action. I set the OData adapter here as the URL is assigned the existing OData service. This remote URL contains the fields, namely, employee ID, last name, first name, notes, and so on. Next, I will write a query to fetch the data that lies between the index range 1 and 4 from the employees table. First, I call the execute query method and define an instance for the query class. Second, I will make a call to the range method and pass the start and end index values to 1 and 4 to fetch the data set in that range. Next, I define the then function that receives the argument e of type return option. This function will be called on successful execution of the data manager operations. Here, I will access the resultant dataset from the argument e and assign it to a variable result. Here, I import the query class and return option interface from the EJ2 data repository to access this class and interface. Okay, next let's see how to structure the resultant dataset as a JSON collection with a header and content fields. First, I create the variable employee data and assign an empty array to it. Then, I create an object, mapping, and define the fields header to the first name and content to notes, as I am going to fetch these two fields from the resultant data set later. Next, I add a for loop statement to iterate the dataset and push the data to the employee data variable. All data points should be formatted as JSON objects, with the field's header and content. Now, I need to bind this newly formed JSON collection to the tab component. So, I open the app component HTML file and replace the country's collection with employee data to render the tab items based on remote data items. In the output page, the tab component now displays with the remote data source. In this video, we have seen how to load the Syncfusion Angular Tabs component with a remote data source. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.